Hello guys, good afternoon and welcome back to my channel Learn Oracle. Today I am going to show you one brand new video that create a online resume through the Oracle Apex by the help of HTML code. For this video I already created a instruction file here with the HTML code, and finally I will give you the instruction how we can add this CV or online resume page to our employee list page. Okay, so before starting the main video I would like to show you the demo right now. Okay, so for showing the demo I have to log into my workspace DMS and sign in here. As you can see, I run the application and I'm going to log into my account first. Then you can see when I click on add employee page, then you can see the employee list here, and when I click on the resume you will see the resume will open here, right? This is the online resume, and I created this through the help of HTML code. Though we all know that Oracle Apex support the HTML code editor, and by the help of this you can create this beautiful CV. So to those people are still not subscribed to my channel, I hopefully request you that you can please subscribe to my channel and watch the video till end. Okay, so I'm now going to the instruction file right now, then I will show you the step by step creating the page. Okay, so I'm going to application page application builder here, and then I have to create a online resume. So I as a blank page first, I would like to create the online resume. Then for the instruction file, then I also create a static resume by deleting this. So I'll create a static resume, and this name also the online resume, and this global page appear here through the help of the global page, and save these things. And finally I would like to add the HTML code here. Okay, and this is the portion I keep it as static, and through the HTML code I will show you the CV. okay, so I'm going to copy this full code up to the bottom, deep to deep, and I will paste this code in this HTML code editor. Okay, then I will save and run the page. Okay, you can see the same report is created here. So for the explanation of this page, I would like to explain right now. So I'm going here, and as you can see, this is the first division, this is the parent division, and in this portion I name it as CB page, and into this div I will create another div for display the image, and this is the image right here, and finally I will show you the another text data through the article tag and article class, and through the paragraph. Okay, so as you can see, here is the paragraph, and if you wish you can change the name here too. Suppose this name I want to change. Okay, and you want to change the name as your CV, and you want to replace this image to your image. So you have to change the image name first. Okay, and this image I already stored statically into the into my Oracle Apex application shared component. As you can see, when I go into the shared components things, and finally I will find this file here as a this name. Okay, and this is the image name. So right now I use this image as static, but in future when if you wish you can use the dynamic PLSQL code or dynamic HTML, then you will add the image dynamically, not use this static image. Okay, for the tutorial purpose I use the static image here. If you want to see the dynamic biodata or dynamic resume, you just comment me in the video comment section, and hopefully I will make one for you. So today today's CV is static, and this CV I will show you only the static content here, okay? And you can see here is the name. So if I wish, I would like to change this name to my name, okay? I can change this name my name or something. As you can see, I changed the my name here, okay? And when I run these things, then as you can see, this name is MG Abu Said, okay? And you can also use the another HTML property here, just like you can add bold or something B, so you can, okay? So you can use the bold or style or any another tag that available in HTML code. Then you can see this name is already bold, okay? Then you can change the rest of the portion. Suppose this portion and this portion, every portion are available in here, okay? And this is the contact portion. When you, if you want to change the contact portion, then you can change this from here, okay? And I also added a link here to see the online online link of LinkedIn of this person. So I have that person link here, okay? If the LinkedIn sign in, so we can see, we will see this link will appear here, okay? And also you can we can find it find this person here through the help of HTML, okay? And also I added a YouTube tutorial link video, my channel link here, so you can also add your website link there, okay? And by the same way you can have another content of this CV from this portion, okay? So this is the first part, and now I'm going to show you the step 3. Now already I finished these things, and now I'm going to the step 4, and I would like to connect this report to our employee list, okay? So we know that our employee list are present here, add employee, and I already added here, no problem. I will delete this link and show you again. So as you can see, this report didn't have this column, okay? I saved these things, and no problem. I run this space, and what is the problem? No problem. I reload this space, and the problem will gone. Okay, now I save these things, and these things is here because of this column are not deleted, right? So I'd like to delete this first and save this. Okay, now this error will gone. Okay, now there is no link up, and these links we already know that these links perform these things. For our theme customization, this text are not visible, so I'm going to change the theme portion from here, customize theme roller, and I would like to use the suppose by the slat, and then this data is clear right now. So now we can see, and again I would like to show you how we can link this CV, right? So now I'm going to edit this page, and from this employee report section, I would like to create a virtual column. From this virtual column and virtual column name, we can name it as view resume, okay? Resume, and make it as a link. So here is the link. I should use the link from here, and as you can see, I already try to make a online resume to this one. This few second ago we created, and this okay, and okay, save the page, and run this page, and before run, I would like to change the icon from here. I'm just select this icon, so I'm save these things, and run the page. Okay, as you can see, view the resume section, when I click on here, this CV will appear, okay? And hopefully you enjoy the video, and this is the topics that I would like to discuss right here. So, and finally I tell you the enjoy, okay? So this all from the video right now. So the people still not subscribe to my channel, I request you again to please subscribe to my channel and share my video, like my video, and comment in the video section if you have any queries or complaint of, or if you want a new updated logic or updated concept that you want to learn, then hopefully I will share the concept if I know. Okay, thank you so much. So today after this, so next tutorial I will create another portion that will show you then the how we can beautify our Oracle Apex button using the CSS and JavaScript. As you can see here, I already created that four button, and in later on video I will modify this through the use of JavaScript and CSS code. Okay, so stay tuned for the next video, and see you later. Thank you. Bye.